So where were you during the great Facebook blackout of 2021? Sounds dramatic. But for 6 hours yesterday, users around the world found themselves unable to share or like or post anything. Facebook and its apps, Instagram, WhatsApp, Messenger, and Oculus went offline. Facebook says the problem was a networking issue. The company's chief technology officer issued an apology on Twitter that reads, "To every small and large business, family, and individual who depends on us, I'm sorry." Here to talk about the blackout, tech expert Burton Kelso. Burton, I mean, a lot of people went to Twitter, not just Instagram, to share with us what was happening, but it forced everyone to use the only social media that seemed to be working yesterday. So, I mean, beyond everything that we're kind of making fun of, the fact that we probably needed to unplug, the fact that we got more work done because we weren't distracted by social media, how big of a deal was this?
That's a pretty big deal, and you can't forget about LinkedIn in this outage too, because that's another social media network that people gravitated to. But it's a huge deal because many small businesses rely on Facebook and Instagram to market their businesses and to stay in communication with their current and potential customers. And the same thing with Instagram. So it's major. It just means that people just can't communicate in a way that they're normally used to doing. And it just essentially shut everything down on the internet.
And it was coupled with the whistleblower story at the same time as the headlines were going out. We had this outage, and a lot of people were trying to come up with theories about what could have happened and who hacked Facebook. But it was this faulty configuration change, according to Facebook. What does that mean?
It basically means that Facebook could have been doing internal maintenance on their networks, and you had an IT employee just put the wrong settings in the router, which took Facebook and Instagram and WhatsApp off the internet. It can happen. I mean, it's always good to speculate that hackers got into Facebook.
Yeah, but thankfully it wasn't a hack, because I think a lot of people are concerned about their personal data, but this was an internal tech glitch. How much could this cost?
Well, Facebook's stock price dropped nearly 6% yesterday, so the company lost about $50 billion. But I think more importantly, I think you're going to see a loss in confidence in people using the social media network. As you said earlier, people went to Twitter to get on and communicate with people, but you could see more people start to leave Facebook in light of this outage yesterday.
And again, really, really quickly, we have 1 minute left, Burton, but with the negative publicity of the outage coupled with the whistleblower's story and her testifying to Congress today, do you think that that kind of bad publicity will have a lasting impact, or will people kind of say, eh, and move on?
I think it's going to have a lasting impact, just for the simple fact that you've had the Cambridge Analytica break back in 2018. And now people are upset that they can't express how they feel on Facebook, and they are being censored as far as their content. So I think you're going to start to see a migration away from Facebook to other social media platforms.
Well, we'll see how this all plays out. Burton Kelso, our go-to guru from the tech world, thanks so much for being with us this morning.
Thank you, Adrian. Have a good one.
If you're a Missouri